to my channel. My name is Florence. To all my returning subscribers, thank you so much for always coming back. I really appreciate you. And if you're new here, if this is your first time of seeing my face, you're very much welcome. On this channel, I make videos on love life, motherhood, African food, faith, and all the good stuff. So in today's video, I want to continue with the courtship series that I've been on for some weeks now. And I want to share another tip with you on how to build strong friendship while you are courting. You know, I've established before that friendship is very, very important for two people that are courting and heading towards marriage. You know, it's very, very important for you to have that strong friendship. So in today's video, I want to share another tip with you, and that is why you should pray together. The significance, the importance of praying together while you are courting. There's this saying that goes thus, that hearts that pray together, that they knit together. The family that prays together stay close together. So it is very important while you're courting, two partners are courting, and you are sure that that courtship is heading towards marriage, it's very important for you to try and be praying together, for you to develop the attitude of praying together. Don't wait until you are married before you start praying together. It's even good for you to get used to it, you know, to have known how to pray together, you know, how to agree together in prayer concerning one issue or the other, right from while you are courting. And that thing is that, in fact, you'll be having a lot of answered prayers while you're courting, even before you get married. You know, there is this word of God that says that where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in their midst. And then the Bible also says that if two of you shall agree concerning something, that our Heavenly Father will do it for us. So it's very important for you to try and develop that attitude of praying together, the two of you praying together, you know, to get answers, you know, to intercede concerning your future home together. And you know, this praying together can be a physical meeting. Maybe you meet in a particular place to pray together, or probably via phone or via the internet. There are different platforms now through which you can pray together, maybe Zoom or maybe WhatsApp, different platforms now that you can pray together. Remember when I and my husband were courting, then there's this network provider in Nigeria called MTN, and they had a particular offer at that time that if you subscribe to that offer, you'll be able to make a free call between 12:30 a.m. in the middle of the night to 4:30 a.m. So we bought new sims at that time and we subscribed to it, and at that time we used to pray together, you know, on phone at the middle of the night, although it wasn't an everyday thing. So it doesn't have to be an everyday thing if you know that that won't be comfortable for you. I think maybe we were praying for like maybe twice or thrice a week, and you know, in the middle of the night we woke up, you know, we pray together and all that. And even right from when we were courting, we start having answers to our prayers. You know, we agree about one thing or the other that each of us wants from God, and we're having answers to our prayers right from where we were courting. So by the time we now got married, it wasn't difficult for us to agree together and pray for one thing or the other, because we were already used to praying together, you know, joining our hands and agreeing together on one thing or the other. So it's very, very important for you to develop this attitude while you're courting. Let me share with you some benefits of, you know, praying together while you're courting. Number one is that there will be this gradual consciousness of becoming one, because now the two of you, you are now agreeing together, you know, to achieve things, to fight, you know, to fight for things in the spirit, you know, to achieve one thing or the other that you are aiming to achieve. Do you understand? So there's this, you know, gradual consciousness of you becoming one, although you are not yet married. Do you understand? So that's a good one. Then another thing is that there will be a change of mindset from temporary to permanent. You are no more seeing yourself as, okay, I'm just a friend to this person, okay, we are just courting. Of course, you are still courting, but you know, you're already having that change of mindset of just being a temporary person in this person's life, you know, to somebody that is becoming a permanent person in this person's life. Do you understand? So by this, you know, you'll be becoming more serious with the relationship, be taking the relationship more seriously than before. Then another benefit is that, just like I said earlier, you'll have developed, you know, the attitude of praying together, of agreeing together, right from while you're courting. So that by the time you get married, you won't just have to start doing that. Just like, you know, I told you the other time concerning I and my husband while we were courting. So it's a very good thing for you to, you know, develop that attitude while you're courting. Another benefit of praying together while you're courting is that it will help you to be able to weigh the spiritual state of your partner. You know, by the time you pray together with somebody, you will know if they are if they know how to pray or not. You will know how grounded they are in the scriptures, in the word of God, if they know the word of God enough or not. You will know their understanding on how to pray as well. That's another aspect to it. Then another thing is that you will know if they even love praying, if they love spiritual things and all that. So by the time you pray together, you'll be able to weigh the spiritual level, the spiritual state of your partner, and you will know if this person is just was probably pretending to be a spiritual person or not. So that's another very good benefit of praying together while you're courting. So in overall, I'll say that it is very beneficial, very vital, very crucial for you to pray together while you're courting, once you're sure that that courtship is heading towards marriage. Now, I want to mention something here, that if the two of you are always praying together, that doesn't mean that you shouldn't have your own personal time of praying to God. Because while you're courting, you're still courting, you're not yet married. So probably there are some things that you won't want to share or mention while you're praying together at that time. Do you understand? So because of course it's not everything that you need to discuss with your partner while you're courting. Because you know, in life, relationships have levels. So it's not all courtship. Even if you actually plan that, okay, this courtship is leading towards marriage, not all courtship that eventually leading to marriage. So it's not everything that you have to discuss with your partner. There are some things that you have to keep to yourself while you're courting. So such things, it's not necessary for you to mention them while you're praying together. So that's why I, as much as the two of you pray together, you know, intercede for your future home and all that, you should also have your own personal time of praying together. So it is at such time that you mention those personal things to God. Do you understand? So this is very, very necessary for you to note. Another thing is that, you know, you will have a lot of victories together. You know, because the Bible says that one shall chase 1,000 and two shall chase 10,000. So when the two of you pray together, you will achieve a lot of things, you know, a lot of victories when you pray together. So it's very, very important for you to inculcate this in your courtship. Meanwhile, I want to mention here that as much as you try and pray together, if you must, you know, meet physically to pray together, try and meet in a place that maybe people are around, you know, people are passing by and all that, not in a secluded place, you know, and you don't have to join your hands together before you can agree on something. Do you understand? This is just to, you know, try and protect yourself from temptation. You understand? You don't want to start, you know, smooching and start falling into sin if that is not what you want to do. So don't expose yourself to temptation. So I need to mention this, that you should try and, you know, take some caution, exercise some caution while you're praying together. This is where I'll be stopping as far as this tip is concerned. And I hope you have learned one or two things from this video. So if you have not subscribed, kindly subscribe to my channel and turn on your notification bell so that whenever I post a new video, you can be notified immediately. Kindly like and share this video also if you find it helpful. So till I see you again in my next video, bye!